just heard the wonderful sounds of the Ohio Players. Welcome, welcome, welcome. It is Monday. Like I said, I am now, they moved me. And so now I am on Mondays at 7:30. It is time for the My Spa Bath and Body Show. And I'm really kind of loving this time spot because I see people coming on my Facebook Live feed. And also we're on VoxWave.com, VOXWAV.com. So I see Walter and Roz Joyce joining me. And that kind of sounds like I'm on Romper Room. But we are live in the VoxWave studios. And I'm just so happy to be here today. We are talking about something that is on everybody's mind right now. I mean, it is hot outside. Hot, 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 hot. And, you know, we've grown up with a lot of different habits that we've developed. So we wake up and we take our shower, and then we use our aluminum deodorants, and we use our talcum powders, and we don't give it a second thought. But really we should, especially when we have an opportunity to make different choices. So today, the name of my this episode is Don't Sweat It Naturally. Yay! So, and thanks for all the shout outs for my new hairstyle. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So what are we talking about today? We are going to talk about different ways to keep yourself odor-free, funk-free, without any toxins. So that is what our subject is. So today we're going to talk about some natural ways to keep yourself soft and dry. Because as you know, there are a lot of different toxins in a lot of the things that we do. And most popularly is the fact that it's summertime and we're used to using a lot of talcum powder, especially women. And if you caught me on a different episode, you would know that there, as far as with African American women and with a lot of other women, we have a tendency to overcompensate with our hygiene and using different products. And unfortunately, we find out that it is talcum powder can be dangerous for women. It is a ground material that was the basis for most dusting and baby powders for many years. Then it was found out that sometimes it's contaminated with asbestos fibers that are linked with lung cancer, as well as other respiratory illnesses. Also, it can, when if it gets into a woman's vagina and up her birth canal, we know now that it can cause ovarian cancer when it's used on a repetitive basis. There was, of course, the court case in the U.S. where a woman's family successfully sued Johnson & Johnson for their contaminated baby powder. The family argued that their mother's use of baby powder in her genital area led to her death by ovarian cancer. The courts agreed, and Johnson & Johnson was ordered to pay $72 million in damages. Now there's a class action lawsuit of over 1,200 women who are suing the company for their use of this known harmful ingredient for years. Now here's the interesting part is, in doing this research, I went on Johnson & Johnson's website and looked up Johnson & Johnson's baby powder. And first thing I saw, they had a press release that said that they were slowly going to stop using talc for their baby powder. But that was the press release. If you look still on the Johnson & Johnson website and you look at the ingredients to their baby powder, it is talc and perfume. And there's no disclaimers or warnings or notices about, you know, using care when you're using these products or anything. It's just business as usual. Because what I've learned is a lot of these companies, they play the odds. They play the odds. So $72 million from a, you know, $6 or $7 billion company, I don't know if that's the amount that they make, but Johnson & Johnson is a pretty big company. It's just a drop in the hat for them. So they play the odds. Are you going to sue them or are you going to get sick? And hopefully you won't. So you have to understand that a lot of these companies, they really don't care about you. They care about the bottom line. So, but we don't have to worry about that because you're watching my show and you are going to learn about different things that you can use. Okay, so the first, there's the most basic replacement that you can use for talcum powder is a combination of cornstarch and baking soda. And everybody knows what baking soda looks like, but, you know, good old Argo cornstarch. And so you would use 2 cups of cornstarch and 2 cups of baking soda and 10 to 15 drops of essential oil of your choice. Some of the recipes include cinnamon, but I wouldn't use ground cinnamon on my skin because it may be sensitive. But like I say, the basic is the cornstarch and the baking soda. Just mix those two ingredients plus some essential oils that we'll talk about in a few minutes in your container. And you can use an old shaker. You can get a spice shaker from the dollar store. You can get a jar and poke holes in it and use that to sprinkle it on. And one good thing you can also do is add rice to it to keep it from clumping. Or if you buy, you have shoes or a purse or something that has that little silica pack, you can put that at the bottom of your container and that will absorb any moisture and keep it from clumping. So you can just start off basic like that. Of course, like I said, we talked about talcum powder. Also, fragrances can be very irritating as well. So another ingredient that you can use is kaolin clay. And kaolin clay is very absorbent of toxins and odors and things like that. And I actually sell a facial cleanser on my website, www.myspa.etsy.com. It's called Face It Facial Cleanser. That has kaolin clay in it. But it's very good, especially for sensitive skin. It's naturally absorbent and helps to prevent chafing and rashes. It's not very strong, so it doesn't pull the oils out of your skin, so it won't cause dryness. So you can find it at a lot of health food stores. Another type of powder you can use is arrowroot powder. I got this at a industrial store, but it's very powdery and light and absorbent as well. It is made from the starch of the root of a plant. It's a fine powder that is a fantastic base for dusting and baby powders as it will absorb extra moisture. Arrowroot is often used as a substitute for cornstarch for thickening sauces. So you may find this in a health food store, grocery store, or bulk store, which is where I got mine. Okay? So of course you use it before you go outside or, you know, afterwards. So I'm gonna give you another recipe. Again, you know, get any kind of jar that you want. And this one is you mix 1 part kaolin clay to 2 parts of the arrowroot powder. And then you add your essential oils. Okay? So another thing that you can do, though, is that you can make your own deodorant. Again, using those aluminum and all that other stuff can be pretty bad on your health and all of that. So there's a way that you can make your own deodorant as well. Okay? Reasons you want to do that is no nasty chemicals, no parabens, which if you've watched my show, you know that I hate parabens. Those are all of those types of preservatives that are supposed to prevent growth of mold in your deodorant, but they also are hormone disruptors. And of course, talked about aluminum, and aluminum is said to cause or contribute to breast cancer. It also it blocks the sweat ducts to prevent excessive sweating, but is also said to cause growth of breast cancer cells by mimicking estrogen. Then there's triclosan, which is a pesticide, and it's used as an antibacterial in store-bought deodorants, but it aggravates allergies, it causes hormonal imbalances, inflammatory conditions. It may even cause you to gain weight, which is kind of weird. So if you're going to make your own deodorant, that's, again, very, very simple. So what you would do is you would use 4 tablespoons of coconut oil, which is my favorite little coconut oil here. 5 tablespoons of cornstarch. A tablespoon and a teaspoon of baking soda. And 20 drops of lemon eucalyptus essential oils. Okay. What each ingredient does. The baking soda and cornstarch are going to absorb sweat and neutralize the stink. Coconut oil is going to be an anti-inflammatory, moisturize your skin, prevent skin irritations and rashes, and also keeps the deodorant nice and creamy. And then the lemon eucalyptus oil is going to absorb some of the odor. And it's a bug repellent. So if you are outside and you don't want to sweat and don't want to get bitten by the mosquitoes, you're ready. So what you would do is you would combine all the ingredients in a pan over a low flame until everything melts. Then let everything cool off and pour it into a glass jar. Add the lemon eucalyptus essential oil and stir well. And that way you have your own deodorant. Okay, you can store it in a room temperature in a dark place, and it should last over 3 months. Of course, to use it, you just scoop it out and rub it on, and you're good. So those are the homemade deodorants and your homemade dusting powders. Now, if you have an issue, a health issue that's causing you to sweat excessively or any other type of ailments, nothing that I have said is meant to provide medical advice to cure or address any disease. The FDA has not approved my statements, but if you're in reasonable health, you can try these. If you have any health concerns, make sure you call your doctor and see them. I always have to say that because, you know, it's interesting. The FDA, like I say, they approve stuff that has side effects. But I have to make sure that I give my disclaimer so that I'm safe. So say, though, you have just regular excessive sweating. I'm going to give you some ways to take care of that, too. If you have excessively sweat, that is called hyperhidrosis. So these are some to address that, as well as just regular sweat. So nutritional deficiencies, stress, anxiety, and poor circulation can trigger excessive sweating. People with diabetes, heart problems, obesity, and hyperthyroidism are more prone to it. And it can make you disrupt your routine life, you know. So you're sitting there sweating profusely with sweat rings, and then the person sitting across from you is looking at you like, what's up with you? Why are you sweating like that? So, you know, those things, even though it won't kill you, it definitely affects your social interactions and, you know, your work environment and all of that if you're just sitting there sweating profusely. So I'm going to give you some more home remedies for excessive sweating that still fit into our natural profile. First thing you can use is apple cider vinegar. It has an astringent property that controls the sweating process. It helps to balance the pH levels of the body, especially under the arms and feet. And it gets rid of bacteria. Being an antiperspirant, it forms a coat on the skin which ensures the pores are closed. So apple cider vinegar, what you would do is you take, use a cotton ball, apply the apple cider vinegar, and rub it on your armpits before going to bed. Wash it off overnight. And do it every night. If it's too strong, of course, dilute it with water. Apple cider for sweaty feet. 1 liter of water and 1/2 cup of apple cider vinegar in a foot basin. And soak your feet for 15 to 20 minutes. Of course, me, I think I talked about this. My apple cider vinegar, I'm going to put some Epsom salts in there and some tea tree oil for additional antibacterial and relaxing And that's wonderful. Lemon is another remedy for extensive sweating. I have some lemon essential oils here. And the citric acid, it's the citric acid that eliminates the bacteria. But one thing always, whenever you're using anything with lemon, bergamot, especially bergamot, in the sun, do not go outside with anything with bergamot because it'll make your skin super sensitive to the sun. Bergamot, lemon, orange, you know, wait 12 hours. So anything I'm talking about doing with the lemon, you want to do it at night. So for if you have a problem with your armpit sweating, mix a teaspoon of lemon juice and baking soda in a small bowl. Apply the paste under your armpits thoroughly by using a cotton ball and let it sit for 20 to 30 minutes. Then wash it off. Do this every night. Or if you don't want to do that, just rub half a lemon under your arms by gently squeezing it. So instead of going like this with your deodorant, do it with your lemon and leave it on for 15 to 30 minutes. But make sure, again, that you do this at night because it'll make you photosensitive, which is not good. Lemon for body sweating. Of course, mix 1 to 2 tablespoons of lemon juice with 1 tablespoon of salt in a small bowl and apply this on sweat-prone areas of your body. And massage gently with your hands for a few minutes. I would recommend not doing this on any freshly shaved areas because it can cause irritation. Baking soda. I love baking soda. Just period. I just love it. So what baking soda does, it's an alkaline in nature which effectively lowers the pH level of your sweat-prone areas by counteracting the acids. It's also a natural deodorant. So what you do is combine enough amounts of baking soda and cornstarch, and of course clean your underarms thoroughly and apply the mixture under them and leave it on for 30 minutes and rinse it off with water. Or you can take a bath in baking soda, which is always very good. And then also with that, what I would do, of course, is if I'm applying that under my arms, I would also add a little activated charcoal and use that same powder combination on your feet. And you can sprinkle it in your shoes as well. Next thing is coconut oil. We've talked about coconut oil enough around here, and we already talked about how to use that in making your own deodorant. Here's a fun one, a potato. You can actually, I think I'm going to talk about tomatoes too. But potatoes, their ability to absorb excess water from the body, it is known as an antiperspirant. You knew that, Ron? So you save money on your deodorant? Okay. Well, what you can do is rub a small potato piece on the sweat-prone areas for a few minutes and let the potato absorb the excess sweat and prevent sweating more and leave it to dry completely before wearing clothes. Or you can apply some potato juice, and leave it to dry completely. Extract the potato juice, pour it into an airtight container, and refrigerate it for daily use. I wonder if you can just use mashed potatoes. You can't mash them and smash them underneath your... Okay. All right, the next thing is black tea. The tannic acid presented in black tea holds astringent and antiperspirant properties. They provide relief from excess sweating. Okay, so what you want to do is place your 2 black tea bags in 3 cups of hot water. Let steep for about 10 minutes and then dip a washcloth in the tea and put it on your underarms. Or you can just take the tea bags and stick them under your arms too for a few minutes. 10 to 15 minutes. Yep. And then black tea for feet and palm sweating. You do the same thing that you would do for the apple cider vinegar foot soak. You soak your feet with two tea bags. And as I always say, I put in that tea tree oil or some of the other oils we're going to talk about to eliminate that odor as well. Sage. Sage, we'll talk about that, but you can use sage. Chamomile is good. Everybody has a chamomile tea bag around. And it has antibacterial, astringent, and deodorant properties that make it a best remedy for treating excess sweating. Its antibacterial property helps to eliminate the bacteria, which produce the body odor and sweat. So, of course, you get your chamomile tea bag and steep it for a few minutes. And you can drink it. That'll help to cool you down and just kind of slow down your sweating. Or you can soak a cotton ball or pad in the tea and apply to sweat-prone areas for a few minutes. Okay? So that chamomile tea, that is a great thing to add to your hygiene to stop you from sweating so much. Okay? Or you can add a few drops of chamomile essential oil to a bath of warm water and take a bath in that daily. Witch hazel. Y'all know how much I love witch hazel. Yes. And witch hazel is, the good thing about witch hazel, it is just so inexpensive. You don't have to, some places, if you go to CVS and get that brand name Dickinson, sometimes they want to charge you $6 or $7. Just go to your local Target and pay $3. And this is just a wealth of uses in witch hazel. You just can't drink it, but otherwise, I'll put that up against apple cider vinegar any day. Except for, I haven't tried it in a foot soap, but witch hazel is the bomb. But what it contains everything we need to treat the sweating problem effectively, especially on the face, by shrinking the pores. Okay, you take some witch hazel, put it on you can put it on sweat-prone areas like your armpits, face, and feet, and you can wash it off after 30 minutes or just leave it on. Okay? Tea tree oil, I've talked about that, and we've talked about it, so you know how I feel about that. Tomato juice. Tomato juice is supposed to be good for your skin, too. You know? You can use it on your face to reduce, like, your facial sweating. You apply tomato juice to the affected areas. Let it sit for about 10 to 15 minutes to dry. And then, you know, shower it off. And you're good. Also, you can drink the tomato juice once or twice in a day for a week. And that reduces your amount of sweating. Now, wheatgrass. Wheatgrass is something that you would take internally. It's a wheatgrass juice. You probably have to go to a health food store, not GNC. GNC is a supplement store. It's not a health food store. So wheatgrass juice will help you to control sweating because it's high in vitamin A, C, B12, and folic acid. This effectively prevents the sweating by controlling the acid's activity and toxins in the blood. So it neutralizes and dilutes the toxins in the blood and helps you get complete relief from sweating. And I don't see any contradictions for that. So, like I said, we know how to make that homemade deodorant. I have another recipe for you that has 3 teaspoons of coconut oil, 2 teaspoons of shea butter. You melt that down. And then when it's melted, remove from the heat and add 3 teaspoons of baking soda and 2 teaspoons of arrowroot powder, and then stir in well with essential oils and allow it to cool. Okay, number 15 that we're going to talk about is cornstarch. I already talked about that. You can just use it straight out of here. And you know what? I was making a mess before. But cornstarch, I tell you what, it is such a soft and silky feel on your skin that it's like butter, and it goes into your skin as well, very well. So it's very absorbent. You can't see that there, but you can see it on boxwave.com. It's very absorbent. It goes into the skin very well. So you should have minimal clumping when you use it. So you can use a tissue paper, wipe away the already present sweat, and then dust some cornstarch on the affected areas and leave it to dry completely, and then apply another layer of cornstarch. And of course, you can put this in your socks and in your shoes. And again, always add that charcoal, that activated charcoal. I always have to embellish stuff, make it better. The next is eating magnesium-rich foods. So include in your diet avocados, apples, broccoli, bananas, green leafy vegetables, legumes, nuts, potatoes, seeds, and whole grains. Just make sure that whatever you use on your body, you don't eat it afterwards. So your potatoes, just keep it moving. I'm going to talk a little bit more about the essential oils. I talked about sage. Sage is one of the best essential oils for excessive sweating. The pros of that are they have strong antibacterial and antifungal properties. It's effective in treating hot flashes. It's been found that sage can reduce their intensity and frequency because of hormone imbalances. And so you can use that on there. And here's what, as I go through these, what you can do is, we already talked about the basic powder formula. So depending on what your needs are, you can enhance it. You can use these particular essential oils. Only problem with sage is sage can be its own toxic. It can, pure sage essential oils can induce seizures, it can induce labor, and it should not be used for people with high blood pressure. One good thing is that sage also helps to remove cellulite. It's good for skin and hair care, sweaty hands, feet and underarms. So that's a good one. Clary sage, I've talked about that. That's a great oil, but I can't use it personally because it just messes with me. But it's very good that you can add to your basic powder formula. It's very calming and relaxing. It can help prevent sweating due to stress responses. It has antiseptic and antibacterial properties, preventing infections or bacterial growth. Cons, clary sage has estrogen-like effects and should be used carefully by those with hormone-related problems, such as cancer, fibrosis. And do not use this for a long time if you suffer from asthma. Okay, so it's very good. Palmarosa, I've talked about Palmarosa because Palmarosa is an aphrodisiac. It is. Oh, Ron woke up. But it's very good for sweating too. So it's going to relieve your anxiety. It's going to calm you down. It's going to make you feel better. It's going to get you in the mood. But guess what else it does? It's great for using for excessive sweating. It helps to treat bacterial infections. You would mix this, just a few drops, add a little jojoba oil, that's a dry oil, or argan oil to it. So if you have like 5 drops of your Palmarosa, 5 drops of an argan oil, mix it together. And then when you're adding it to your powders, you want to whisk it. But you don't have to be overly concerned. You just want the essential oils to touch the powder. You can put this in your deodorant too. So it kills bacteria. It helps to heal sores. The scent helps reduce heart palpitations. Well, it can. Of course, if you have anything wrong with your heart, go to a doctor first. It can treat candida yeast infections. So you use this to kill fungus and bacteria. You can apply this to your genital area for vaginal yeast infections or jock itch. So you mix this with your powder that we talked about, the basic powders, you know, your cornstarch and arrowroot, or cornstarch and baking soda, or, you know, cornstarch and kaolin clay. And this is something that once you dust up, you can get your groove on. And everybody's, well, I won't say everybody's nice and dry, because that's kind of not what you're trying to do if you're trying to get your groove on. But, and however, at least you have, you're killing all of the bacteria and germs and being sweat-free. And, let's say funk-free, unpleasant funk-free. How's that? It alleviates urinary tract infections, viral infections, reduces fever. And like I say, it's for women, it is very good. It chills them right out. Let's see. I got a lot more information. Palmarosa is good for acne, psoriasis. It helps to rejuvenate your skin. It's wonderful. Let me see. Neaoli oil. I have that. I sell a neaoli oil and charcoal soap on my website, www.myspa.etsy.com. And that's very good for sweating as well. It is made, and it's called Neaoli oil, N-I-A-O-U-L-I. It's from Australia, and it is wonderful. It is an analgesic. It kills bacteria. It promotes growth and boosts health by promoting proper absorption and distribution of nutrients in the body. It helps to heal scars. And it also helps to lower your body temperature if you have a fever. And it's also a stimulant. So it stimulates your circulation, your enzymes, and your juices. Kills intestinal worms. That's good news. Okay. Other ones that you can use are for adding to your basic powder or your basic deodorant recipe are peppermint, petitgrain, pine, rosemary, and rose geranium. Rose geranium is said to be one of the best essential oils for eliminating oils and sweat. Balances hormones, relieves stress, reduces depression, minimizes inflammation, improves circulation, benefits the health of your skin, and wrinkle reducer, muscle toner. It does a whole lot of things. So, mental functioning improver. So, all of this is really good. And these are all different types of essential oils that you can add to your basic dusting powder, body powder, whatever you want to call it, to stay away from talc products. So, I think that I am done. I have a good and encouraging word for you. So I'll be back with you in 30 seconds. What you gonna play for me, Ron? Ron, he's gonna have a good tune for me. Did I catch you off guard?
Backbone's gone.
Backbone's gone.